Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So Groq with a Q has been in the news lately. It hit Hacker News because it was so blazingly fast at LLM inference. And if you go to groq.com, you can try it for yourself. Right now it just has two models, Llama 70B and Mixtral. But if you try it out, you'll see speeds of up to 300 and sometimes even past 300 tokens per second, which is actually really fast. So I wanted to understand what about their architecture makes it so fast. And I'm sure they have a ton of secret sauce, but on their webpage, they do link to a couple of papers that they published. The last one is from 2022, so I went and took a look at that, and that's what I want to talk about today. And this is a paper where they describe their hardware architecture and the software stack on top of it that targets that hardware architecture and how they achieved this kind of performance. Now, I'll confess I'm not a hardware guy. My expertise tops out at the computer architecture class I took back in undergrad. But I think I still managed to get the key ideas out of this paper. So let's dive in and look at least some of the main ideas in this paper. If I were to summarize it in one sentence, the main idea of this architecture is to achieve performance by removing as much non-determinism as possible. In fact, it looks like they have removed all non-determinism in this system. Now, what does that mean? If you look at the way workloads, whether it's a machine learning workload or anything else, the way workloads are executed on GPUs or even CPUs, in the hardware and memory architecture itself, there are all these sources of non-determinism. You have dynamic RAM, you have various levels of caches, L1, L2, L3. And the reason they're non-deterministic is that they are shared between different processes. And then when memory is shared, the way you achieve consistency and atomicity is by having locks or mutexes on that memory. And so sometimes you might have to wait until you acquire a lock, and that level of parallelism gives you a lot of non-determinism in that you can't predict when you might have to wait on a lock. In stark contrast with that shared memory architecture, which gives rise to a lot of non-determinism, what they're doing over here is constructing a new architecture. They call it TSP, short for Tensor Streaming Processor, that completely statically and ahead of time deterministically maps out or compiles the execution and memory out onto their processing units down to when they communicate with each other and how they execute various threads of control in parallel. So in this entire architecture, the compiler pre-compiles or pre-computes the layout of the memory and the sequence and communication between independent threads of execution. And so there are no locks at all in the execution of this entire system. And it looks like that is the key architectural decision which leads to the mind-blowing performance that we've been seeing. This is what their hardware software stack looks like. You can still have all your applications written in the things you're used to, things like PyTorch or Keras, but they have a compiler based on MLIR. By the way, I have another video on this channel that explains what MLIR is, how it works, and that gets further compiled down to the assembly language of their hardware. This is still a distributed system. You have individual chips. Multiple chips are on a card. They package them into a PCI card. There are multiple such PCI cards within one node, which is one server. And then there's multiple servers in an entire data center rack. And so all these different pieces of physical compute still need to talk to each other to accomplish a given computation. And all this heavy lifting is done by their compiler. Paradoxically, this lets them achieve determinism in a large distributed system like this. Each chip doesn't have dynamic RAM, it has static RAM, and you can read and write it without needing locks or mutexes. The way they communicate with each other is with explicit send or receive messages at specific times, in the computation. The compiler will look at the entire computation ahead of time, figure out the dependencies among them, and then compute out of it a temporal layout in time of those computations and what sends and receives need to happen to accomplish that computation so that all the nodes can work together. And the way they achieve this synchronization in real time is by every chip having hardware counters that are synced with all the other chips in this distributed system. They call these hardware aligned counters. And their instruction set has instructions which sync between chips so that they can all have a common view of where they are in real time. So they can communicate their counters to each other, they can sync with each other, they can even deskew in case they have some drift at execution time. And this does away with so many of the problems that you see in typical dynamic systems. Just one example is when you communicate over a network between nodes in a system. In conventional systems, you will have some notion of back pressure when one node is hotspotting. In this architecture, since the compiler lays out everything statically ahead of time, there is no contention at all. Again, there are no locks to wait on. There are no locks to acquire. All the chips sync with each other using this hardware-aligned counter, and then computation just moves forward in lockstep. And this gives your system very even predictable behavior. For example, when you're doing large matrix multiplication, comparing with an NVIDIA A100, just looking at utilization, the TSP's utilization is consistently high. And here you can see how throughput in teraflops scales linearly as you add more TSPs while keeping utilization pretty high at nearly 70%. And not only does this give you really low latency when you're running inference on large models, it also gives you really predictable latency. This is a graph of running inference on BERT across 24,000 runs. And on the x-axis is the inference latency in microseconds. And on the y-axis is what fraction of inferences had that latency. So it's a latency histogram. And you can see how all the inferences were between 1185 and 1205 microseconds. So within a really tight band. This red line here is the latency that was predicted by their compiler, because it's just laying out all the computation ahead of time so it can predict what the latency is going to be. And the actual latency is within 2% of what was predicted by the compiler. So that was a quick look at the Groq paper explaining what kind of hardware architecture they've implemented to make inference on large models on LLMs so fast and so predictable. The main idea seems to be that they've just ruthlessly removed all sources of non-determinism from the system. And as a result of that, they've achieved not just high performance, but extremely predictable performance. It'll be really interesting to see where Groq goes from here and what impact they have on the machine learning hardware market. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please consider subscribing, like the video, leave a comment, and I will see you all next time. Thank you very much.